One of the challenges of many administrators in small to medium-sized organizations is how to centrally manage their environment, including their servers, server health, server certificates, and many more. One of the options is to constantly switch between the servers and check the server manager. But is it sustainable? Not at all. It requires a lot of time, and you will not be notified if you're not logged into that server. The other solution is to have one Windows server using the server manager and adding the other servers to that specific server manager. While this gives you a lot more central look and feel, it is not the best practice either. It does not give you all the insights you need for administrations. My name is Ali, and in this short video, I'm going to introduce Windows Admin Center, the solution for centrally managing all Windows servers. Windows Admin Center is the central location for managing and monitoring all your systems and server aspects. You can check your certificates, check the registry, add or remove programs, roles or features, and many more. Join me on this video and I will show you how to download and install Windows Admin Center for free. Let's start. From your favorite search engine, search for Windows Server Admin Center. Click the link from Microsoft website and click Download Windows Admin Center. On the next page, click Download the MSI, fill in the form and click Download. After your download is finished, run the Windows installer file and follow the wizard. First, you need to accept the license terms and conditions and then decide which diagnostics data would you like to send back to Microsoft. On the next page, you can define which ports Admin Center will use to communicate with other servers. It is best to leave it to its default unless you have other applications that are using the same port. If you change the port number, make sure to check the firewall settings as well. Click Create a Desktop shortcut and click Install. Depending on your computer speed, the installation might take a few minutes. After the installation is finished, select Open Admin Center and click Finish. System will prompt you to select the right certificate on your first use. Once the Admin Center is running, it will also start updating some of its own extensions. Wait for the update to finish before using the system. This will not take long. You can now see that there are quite a significant amount of information about your servers available. You can see the list of apps and features installed on the server, look at the local users and groups, check the registry, and many more things. Now you can start adding your servers to the Admin Center by selecting the Add button on the left top corner of your screen. Admin Center allows you to add Windows Server, Windows 10 and 11 devices, Windows 365 PC, server clusters, and even Azure VMs. Select the option that suits your need and click Add. You can add servers by typing the name, searching the Active Directory, or import a list of servers from a list. If you're not sure about the name or you don't remember the full name of your server, you can also use wildcards in the search area. Once you've added your servers, you can easily click on each server name and have access to all the settings and information, or even select PowerShell and run the Windows commands. This will run the commands remotely on those servers. You can even install or uninstall roles and features, check the certificates, and do a lot more. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more videos like this. Make sure to hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Also, leave a comment in the comment section down below and let me know what other subjects would you like to learn. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you on the next video.